several key stops. We had three first-half touchdowns. The quarterbacks are playing extremely well. Alternating quarterbacks, still playing a lot of players on defense, which I like. A lot of depth there, keeping them fresh. It's still hot out there. Stay in your game plan. Don't turn the ball over. We've been doing a good job there, and we'll find a way to win, I hope.
Absolutely. So we're just moments away from this First American National Bank kickoff here. Hinds will receive to start the second half after the Indians won the toss and elected to start the ball game with the football. So this will be Zach Ellis to tee things off here for the Indians, being brought to you by the First American National Bank there in Fulton. We do invite you to grab an ice-cold Coca-Cola, sit back, and hopefully enjoy what could be a big second half here for the Indians as they lead 21-13. We'll see what teams or what adjustments these teams made here during the break. Kind of close quarters between Jim and I, we're trying to adjust here. We do want to say a special thank you to Miss Tina Harlow back in Amory, running things for us here as Zach Ellis steps into this First American National Bank kickoff to start the second half, and it's going to be taken at the 15-yard line. Gets a break and open up the middle. Slips past one guy. He's got one man to beat. Breaks off another tackler. Indians going to have to try to make a play here, and he slips down and falls, and my, oh my, what a big-time break there for the Indians, as that was not what the Indians wanted, but a break there for Hinds, or I should say a break there for the Indians, as the receiver tried to juke the guy, lost his footing, and falls down.
That was Pickett on return. And give Deion Knox some credit. He was the last man there for ICC, and he calls the guy to do too much. He lost his balance. So I give Knox credit for the tackle.
Knox did a great job hustling all the way across the field to cause that stumble. Ladies and gentlemen, do apologize as there is a light on in the coaching staff room for Hinds, so you'll see a glare for those watching here on letsgoicctv.com. Xander, pass, little bubble screen, fumble on the play. Do the Indians have it? I believe they do.
Did he call it incomplete or a fumble?
Are they going to say it's incomplete, or are they going to call it a fumble? We're waiting the official signal from the referee, the line judge. Fumble. Indians get the football.
Big time play by defensive back. Guidry had the ball. Took a big hit, fumble. I don't know who got the recovery there, Adam. I missed a replay.
I believe it was number 30, Kenny Wooten, that came up with the football. You talk about momentum, jumping from one side to the other. But, Jim, I do think the Hinds faithful may have a legit argument saying that he never really controlled the football, but the official said he made a football move. And as we saw last weekend on the big boys level, you really don't know what a catch is anymore in the game of football.
No, you don't.
So it's going to be a first down and 10 situation here for the Indians. Give is going to be to Octavius Matthews. He's trying to knife his way forward, fights forward for a minimum gain, maybe a gain of one on the play that time by the commit to Auburn.
Bender's back in the quarterback, Adam. It's a big play there. It's a turnover that we got the ball back. We just started the third quarter. If you're just joining us, ICC 21, Hinds 13, 14, 15 left in the third quarter.
And, Jim, how big was that trip up now on the kickoff return? Matthews gets the ball to go out and just streak down the sideline. Nice receptions. They just loaded it out there. And, Jim, that's what we said. Get him on the corners and big things can happen.
Good job of Matthews. Did reach the corner. Got to the 45-yard line. Sets up a third down. Third and two for the Indians. The ball, we'll call it third and three. The ball's at the 44-yard line.
So a gain of six on the play that time. I've got it unofficially. 12 of 17 for 165 yards for Bender on the evening. Ellington, I believe, now is in at quarterback for the Indians. Third down and four. Little quick dump across the middle to the tight end. It's complete. And Chris Long that time did not go down easy. Beautiful pass play. Little jump pass that time from Dan Ellington to the freshman from Nettleton. Moves the chains.
Good job by Ellington. Good job by the coaching staff. We're bringing in Ellington, who you think might run the little option. He tricked him up, threw the ball to a tight end. First and 10 Indians.
Indians with another first down, being brought to you by your Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox. The give is going to be to Octavius Matthews as he breaks to the outside, but there is a flag down. We'll see what the flag is here. Didn't really see anything on either side of the ball that I thought would warrant a flag, but we are quite far away here in this situation. The flags have not gone in favor of the Indians tonight, as we'll see what the call will be here as we are waiting the call from the head referee.
I saw Matthews use a stiff arm. Surely not calling stiff arm in the face mask against us.
Well, you're typically given that if you don't bend that elbow, and he did give a stiff arm. And I'm telling you what, folks, every time the Indians has had something going tonight, there has been a yellow hanky hit the ground, and it has gone in favor of Hinds throughout the evening. tough break there for the Indians. Now brings up a first down and 25 situation here. Are actually going to mark it off from the spot of the foul, so it's first down and 22. Bender back in at quarterback. Pressure coming, and the first time tonight we've seen Hinds get pressure on the quarterback and knock him down. And Jim, my oh my, it's going to be second down and halfway back to Fulton as the ball now spotted at the 37. We've got to get to the other 33 just to pick up the first down.
That was Sanders, the freshman defensive lineman from Port St. Joe, Florida. Made the tackle, and she mentioned Adam. It's a second down, and I can't even count that much.
The board, I believe, is going to say 30, so a loss of 8 on that sack. Bender going to try to slip it out for a screen pass, and Hinds snuffed that one out from the get-go, and that's going to be no gain on the play as that pass completed to Matthews.
Adam, you mentioned it's third down. We got the ball at our own 37-yard line, and it is third and...
Third and 30.
30.
So the Indians that time try to go the screen play. Hinds read that one nicely. Bender at quarterback. Two receivers on both sides of Bender, one in the backfield. I believe that's Octavius Matthews. Bender making some checks in the line of scrimmage, brings Matthew up to his left. Bender now looking downfield. Got pressure coming. He's going to step forward and loot it. Throws it downfield. Tip ball, and it's intercepted. Whole lot of room to run down those sidelines for the Eagles. Ducking it back across, and he's going to be hit and dropped down around the 25-yard line. Bender that time threw in the double coverage. And anything you can do, I can do better was the theme of the first half. Hinds basically gets the football back where they had it after that last turnover.
Good play by Hinds. And Bender did try to force that pass. It just didn't have enough muster on it. Good play by Hinds. They intercepted the ball. 11:45 left in the third quarter. Indians up 21-13. But Hinds has excellent field position. The ball at ICC's 25.
Yeah, and once again, we do apologize, ladies and gentlemen, for those that are watching on letsgoicctv.com, the red channel. As we said, the light is on next to us by a very vocal Hinds coaching staff. Hopefully you cannot hear anything that's coming across on the microphones there. 21-13 is your score, 11:45 to play here in the third quarter. This third quarter being brought to you by the ICC Wesley Foundations. They meet Tuesday nights at 7. Play action fake. Now they're going to try to go big. Got a man downfield, and it's going to be lost out of bounds. And I tell you what, Jim, that's a break for the Indians because the defensive back never turned around to look for the football. And 9 times out of 10, when you don't make an effort to look back, you're going to be hit with pass interference.
No doubt about it. And if the ball had been in play instead of throwing out of bounds, it could have been a pass interference. But second down, second and 10 for the Eagles. 11:38 left in the third quarter. Indians up by 8.
So second down and 10 is the situation. Indians defense with their back against the wall here. Xander going with a hard snap count, trying to draw the Indians offside, see if they're going to show their cards, and they kind of do. So we'll see if the Indians adjust here with their original defensive plan. Pressure coming up the middle. Jump ball down the sideline, thrown just a little too far. And Xander right now, he's just lobbing them up, trying to go for the big ball. That time, Guidry was the intended receiver, falls incomplete. Bring up third down and 10.
Good job by the Indians. Stop that forward pass. As Adam mentioned, third and 10, 11:30 left in the third quarter. The ball's at the 25-yard line of ICC. This would be a 42-yard field goal if we could hold them right now, 42-yard field goal attempt.
Yeah, for those watching on letsgoicctv.com, Guidry at the bottom of your screen looking towards the sidelines. Now getting the play sent in. Third down and 10, 11:32. Clock is stopped with that last incompletion. ICC defense trying to come up with another big stand here on third down. Hinds surveying the defense. Indians showing pressure coming off the end. They do bring it. Passes away, jump ball, and it's going to be out of bounds again. Well, that time the official was reaching for his flag with the ball thrown 10 yards out of bounds. So Xander, who came out and lit up the Indians in the first half unofficially, 11 of 15 for 175 yards, has thrown 3 straight incompletions to start the third quarter. And we're going to see if they're going to send out the field goal unit, and it looks like they are here. So this could be a big-time kick here to try to get those points back.
No doubt about it, Adam. This is going to be, they're marking the, it's going to be a 42-yard attempt for Solly, who's been kicking the extra points for him.
But Indians do have a man deep to return. If this one is short, it appears to be number 10 for the Indians. Twilly, he's just back in case it's going to be a fake. It's wide left, and the Indians defense bends but don't break. ICC maintains their 21-13 lead here with 11:19 to play. Jim, let's keep it here. Good job by that ICC defense after getting the turnover, giving the offense, giving it back on an interception, able to come back with their back against the wall and make a play.
Adam, the ICC defense has stood up twice now, early in the third quarter with the ball inside our 30-yard line. Great job by defense two consecutive times. Let's take advantage of the good field position here. We got the ball at our own 25-yard line. Looked like Ellington's back in at quarterback.
ICC Director of Development Tyler Kemp listening in here on the broadcast, saying they're doing a great job, so he must be wanting something tomorrow when we're back. No, I'm kidding. Appreciate Tyler listening in. Tyler was supposed to be part of our halftime show, but due to technical difficulties, weren't able to do so. This is going to be a give. This is going to be to Forsythe, and Forsythe with a nice pickup there on first down, rumbling his way through for a gain of about 6, maybe 7 on the play.
Good job. Good blocking by the offensive line. As you mentioned, Adam, 7-yard gain, second down and 3. 11 minutes left in the third quarter. ICC 21, Hinds 13.
They do move the stick back a little bit. They only give him a gain of 6 on the play. 9 carries, 62 yards. Forsythe going to get it again this time. He is going to get hit and hit often, but still able to battle forward for a gain of about 2 on the play. All right, let's see where they spot it. Actually make it a gain of 3, so it's going to be a third down and a long one situation now here for the Indians.
Third down, 3rd and 1 for the Indians. The ball is being marked at the 34-yard line, but there is a timeout.
Timeout. Timeout's taken here by Hinds. We're going to take the timeout with them. ICC 21-13 with 10:43 to go here in the third quarter. Back with more on FM 95 Sports right after this. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Oklahoma, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. Well, excuse me, there may have not been a timeout on the field as the officials are actually over talking to the Hinds head coach. And I tell you what, he is very upset with whatever they called. And I tell you, this head coach is known to be a guy that stays on the field, stays in the hip pocket of the officials. But that time, whatever it was, must have fell on the ears of our deaf ears of the official that time. Bank of Oklahoma scoreboard update. Halftime, East Mississippi leading 14-7 over Gulf Coast. But now they are going to take the timeout. So let's take a look at some more scores from throughout the league. These scores being brought to you by the Bank of Oklahoma. Other scores going on. You've got Jones County 31-3 over Mississippi Delta. That's in the second quarter. Colin 9-0 over Kahoma. That too in the second quarter. Northwest in the third quarter leading 10-7 over Pearl River. 21-7 Holmes over Southwest. That too in the third quarter there. And then in the third quarter, East Central leading Northeast 14-10. Those are your scores from throughout the league being brought to you by the Bank of Oklahoma. John Herod and Company doing a great job there helping bring ICC athletics your way here on letsgoicctv.com as well as FM 95 Sports.
Possession down, Adam. 3rd and 2. We got the ball at our own 33-yard line trying to pick up the first down. We got 8-point lead, 21-13. 10:43 left in the third quarter.
They do, and magically the ball kind of moves back, but there is going to be a carry and a rumble forward for a first down. Nice job by those big guys up front just muscling up and getting that first down, gain of 4 that time for the Indians.
1st and 10 Indians. The ball's at their own 38-yard line. Good job by Ellington following his blockers.
Ellington picks up 4 on that play. I've got him 4 carries for 19 yards, 2 touchdowns for the freshman out of Center Hill High School. 1st down and 10. Ellington stays in at quarterback. He's going to try the run-pass option. This time he's going to be hit, dropped, but still picks up a pretty significant first down, on first down, a gain of 5.
Good job, Ellington. Wanted to throw the ball, wasn't open, tucked it, ran with authority, got 5 solid yards, 2nd and 5 for the Indians. Around 10 minutes left in the third quarter, we're up 21-13.
The Indians would love to tack on some points here and get a little bit more breathing room here from the homestanding Eagles of Hinds. Give is going to be to Forsythe. Forsythe trying to bounce his way forward, kind of gets in that pile, bullying him ahead, and another significant gain of about 3. Now make it 4 on the play for Forsythe. So it's going to bring up a 3rd down and an extremely long one. Let's go ahead and call it 2.
3rd and 2 for the Indians. The ball's thrown 47-yard line. Another possession play here, Adam. We need to find a way to get the first down.
Yeah, the Indians trying to move a little bit of tempo here in the third quarter. 3rd down and a long one, short 2 to go here. They're going to take and reset the offense. Now Forsythe's going to shift to Ellington's right from his left. 3 receivers up top, 1 near the Hinds sideline here for the Indians. Give is going to be to Forsythe. He's hit, stacked up, but I believe that second effort got him the first down. Hinds celebrating like they made the stop, but they're going to turn around and be a little disappointed as they're going to see that moves the chains for another first down being brought to you by your Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox.
Good job by the Indians, and good job by Forsythe running, as we said, north and south, 235 pounds, does a great job, got the first down for the Indians.
Yeah, I think he's a guy that's really going to open some eyes this season through colleges throughout the league. So this is now going to be Matthews, and Matthews is going to be hit and dropped. He's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. Nice job that time by number 34 for Hinds, knifing through the backfield. That's Sanders coming in and making the play, stopping him for no gain.
Second down, second and 10 for the Indians. The ball is at their own 49-yard line. We've got 8 minutes and 40 seconds left in the third quarter. Your Indians are up 21-13.
Good thing is, Jim, that clock continues to roll here in that third quarter, now coming up on 8.5 to play. Man in motion coming to the bottom of the screen for the Indians. Dan Ellington looking to pass. Now he's going to decide to run. Now he's going to load up. He's got a man wide open downfield. He's caught at the 20. Now down to the 15, trying to weave his way through traffic. Great job that time by Dan Ellington, scrambling. Saw a guy and hit him for a big-time gain.
Good job by Terry Williams. He caught the ball, made great yardage. We got first and 10 for the Indians. The ball is at the 13-yard line of Hinds, trying to take advantage of great field position here and tack on another touchdown.
39-yard pass that time makes him an even 100 yards on the evening. Passing on 7-9 is Ellington. Indians hurry to the line of scrimmage. Give is going to be to Octavius Matthews. Matthews lowers his head, fights forward. Matthew, not known as a power runner that time, but really just hammers his way inside the 10-yard line. Looks like that's going to be a pickup of 4, maybe 5 on the play.
He's been watching Forsythe go north and south, and great balance there and great power by Matthews. As we mentioned, 4-yard gain. Second and 6, the ball's at the 9-yard line of Hinds. We're already up 21-13, 7.5 minutes left in the third quarter.
Yeah, Indians knocking on the door here, trying to build on this lead here. This is going to be Ellington looking to run. Now squeaks forward near the 5-yard line, as that was a quarterback option. He just put it in the belly of Matthews that time, elected to keep it. It was able to fight forward for a gain of about 3 on the play.
You mentioned, Adam, gain of 3. I say it's third down, third and a long 3 for the Indians. Great field position. If we don't make it, we got a good shot for a field goal here.
Absolutely. So it's going to be a third down and 3. 7 minutes and counting here. Ellington fakes it. He's got his tight end wide open, and he's going to rumble into the end zone. Touchdown, Indians. Chris Long with his first collegiate touchdown of his career for the freshman out of Nettleton.
Nice job by Chris Long. Nice job by Ellington in the offensive line. And Chris Long has showed up tonight.
Yes.
We're throwing the ball to him. He's a great big target going across the middle. 6'4", 6'5", 250-pounder from Nettleton. Great play by the Indians. We're up 27-13. Ellison for the extra point.
Zach Ellis, a sophomore out of Tupelo, a two-sport athlete at ICC, also a starter for the soccer team. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Ellis gives the Indians a 28-13 advantage here. Is that right? Yes.
Yes,
now they do switch the scoreboard. 28-13 is your score with 6:55 to go in the third quarter. We're going to take a break and be back with more right after this on FM 95 Sports. And let's go ICCTV.com. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Okolona, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. And welcome back to action as we get set for a First American National Bank kickoff. Jim, big-time drive there by the Indians. Couple of turnovers. Indians settle down, march it down the field, and find Chris Long for a 6-yard touchdown strike.
Adam, give the great job of offense, but the defense made 2 great plays down there. When they had the ball inside our 30-yard line, we took advantage of that, went down the field. Good job by Ellington, and Chris Long is showing up big tonight as a big tight end going across the middle.
Yeah, Ellington, another big night for the freshman. 2 rushing touchdowns, now 1 passing touchdown. The other touchdown tonight belonging on a 6-yard touchdown run by Octavius Matthews. 6:55 to play, 28-13 is your score. Indians with the lead as we get set for another First American National Bank kickoff off the foot of Zach Ellis. High kick, end-over-end kick is going to be taken at the 19-yard line, and he's going to be hit and dropped just shy of the 30 as it was the front man that came up, but a big-time hit put on that time by number 34 for the Indians. That's going to be Dalen Fox, the freshman linebacker out of South Haven. So, Jim, first down and 10 here for the Indians. The ball, or excuse me, for the Eagles. The ball is going to be at the 30-yard line, ICC, with a 28-13 advantage. 6:48 to play here in the third quarter. We do want to welcome all those listening on FM 95 Sports and say a special thank you to Miss Tina Harlow back in Amory, running the ship there, doing a great job as always. Tina has got a stressful week ahead of her as her baby girl getting married next weekend, as there's going to be the keeper by Sanders as he's going to get out across the 35-yard line, hit and dropped after about a 7-yard gain on the play by Xander. And Xander is having a nice night. That is going to be his 12th carry unofficially in the contest for 23 yards.
As you mentioned, Adam, good carry by Xander. Second and 3 for the Eagles. 6:25 left into third quarter. 28-13. The Indians up.
Second down and 3 after that pickup of 7. Xander with the football looking to pass. He's got a man open on the sidelines, and this one floats out of bounds. Well, Jim, as we said, Xander lit us up. 175 yards unofficially on 11 of 15 passing in the first half. He's 0-for-4 so far here in the second half.
Defense has stepped up. We've been bending a little bit, but we have not broken, and they're playing very well here in the third quarter. We stopped 2 drives. Now this is the third drive for Hinds. Big third down play, 3rd and 3 for Hinds. 6:12 left in the third quarter. Indians up 28-13.
Yeah, possession down here. The Indians would love to get off the field here on third down and see if they cannot go ahead and start putting this thing to bed with another impressive drive here. You may be able to hear the Hinds coaches calling for the slants on the pass play. Pass across the middle, too far, as it's intended for Guidry, and Guidry upset as he led him ahead that time. He was open, and there's the Indians coming up, possibly forcing Hinds to punt, as it looks like they're going to mull this one over here. Jim, still a lot of time to play in this contest. 6:09 to play here in the third quarter, and now they do send out the punt team.
Xander's had a little bit too much muster on that, and Guidry could not catch up to it. But another great stop by the Indians. We've had now 3 times stopped them solid here in the third quarter.
T. Braden Bishop watching, saying Zach Ellis equals them blankets. Anytime anybody from Tupelo does anything, Braden, the SID at Tupelo High School, Johnny on the spot with the hashtag them blankets.
No doubt about it. And Zach Ellis is 4-for-4 tonight.
Low snap, nearly blocked. And my, oh my, what a booming kick. Salisbury is going to let that one go out of bounds. Jim, what a boot that time by the kicker for Hinds. Got a spiraling kick. Spencer Cole came in and really flipped field position here.
How'd we miss that? We had 3 guys around him. I thought we were going to block the kick.
We've had 3 guys around the football majority of the time tonight on these punts, but credit Cole. He has just really hung in there and really has been a valuable asset for the Eagles tonight as the Indians now have the football. First down and 10. The ball is going to be spotted at the 16-yard line.
And Ellington's back in at quarterback for the Indians.
So Dan Ellington back in at quarterback. Give is going to be to the long running back this time, and he's going to stumble forward for a gain out close to the 20-yard line. Looks like a gain of 3 on the play. And was that Rogers on the carry that time, Jim?
I believe it is.
Yes. Rogers, one of the few times he's actually got to carry the ball tonight. That one going for significant yardage on the play. Gain of, now they're going to say, they say 4 on the board. I'm going to say 3. Play action fake. Has a man across the middle. That went too high. And, oh, a break there for the Indians as they were trying to find number 82 for ICC, Cam Coleman. And it was in and out of the hands of Joseph Nuttle, a freshman out of Forest Hill. And, Jim, you know he'd love to have that one to do over.
No doubt about it. That could have been a pick 6. We were fortunate he did not catch that. Big down here. Third down, 3rd and 7 for the Indians. The ball is back at their own 19-yard line.
So as Jim said, third down, and the board said 6. Ellington looking to pass. Got a man open, wide open down the sidelines. This is just going to be a foot race. One man to beat right here. He's to the 30. Now cuts back across the middle. Zigzagging back and forth, trying to break off a tackle. Does so, and he is going to take it to the house. Touchdown, Indians.
Woo, Terry Williams was wide open. Somebody blew a coverage. Great call. Let's see, Adam. That went 81 yards. To Terry Williams, the redshirt freshman wide receiver. 34-13, Indians up, pending the extra point. What a great play, great call by the coaching staff. No one was around them.
No.
81-yard pass, touchdown Indians.
Big-time play there, and the Indians have grabbed momentum here as that was the fourth touchdown of the contest for Dan Ellington. Two passing, two running. And the Indians awaiting the PAT here, lead 34-13, 5:12 to go in the third quarter. Snap back's a good one. The kick is up, and the kick is true. Zach Ellis puts it through to give the Indians a 35-13 advantage here over the Eagles with 5:12 to play. We're going to take a break and be back with more right after this. ICC 35-13 over Hinds in the third quarter. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Oklahoma, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. And welcome back to action, ladies and gentlemen. The Indians starting to separate themselves here from the Eagles. They're up 35-13, 5:12 to go here in the third quarter as we get set for another First American National Bank kickoff. And Zach Ellis, it's not a bad thing when he's a busy guy on the night.
That's right. He might be fatigued, but we like it, and he likes it. He's 5-for-5, extra points, and he's kicking off for the sixth time tonight.
And so Zach, who will go back home tonight, get a quick nap, get back on the bus, and come back right back to Hinds tomorrow with the soccer team. Ellis puts a foot into this one. End-over-end kick is going to be taken just shy of the 10-yard line. Nice open field tackle that time by the Indians. That's going to be number 9, Quinshay Hurd, with a nice open field tackle as he just got across. They're actually going to spot it at the 25-yard line.
First and 10 Hinds. We got 5 minutes left in the third quarter. The Indians up 35-13.
Yeah, and we do want to apologize if you guys do hear anything out of line here, as we do have a couple of text messages saying they can hear the Hinds coaching staff behind us here. They do have a door, but it's not a closed door. As Mr. Blancett telling Mr. Jim hi, watching
like
there. Paul and Patrick Blancett, a couple of guys that helped me get my start in this business, and his son Austin Blancett tonight running the camera for us. We do appreciate Austin and everything he does here on for the Sports Information Department. Xander on the keeper. A lot of real estate. Runs, drops the football, loose on the field. Scooped up by the Indians. And the Indians going to try to take it to the house. And he's going to be tackled inside the 10-yard line. Jim, when it rains, it pours. And right now it's pouring on the Eagles. That's Donald Twilley with the fumble and the return inside the 10-yard line.
Big-time play by the defense. They've made some great plays here in the third quarter. Let's take advantage of this.
Yeah, I do want to say that was a return of about 23 yards. Looks like they're going to spot the ball at maybe the 13-yard line.
At the 8.
Or at the 8, excuse me. Yeah, it's going to be inside the 10, so it's going to be down at the 8-yard line where the Indians will have it first and 10. ICC may be having to take a little time out here as they have put the ball into play, and the Indians have not broken huddle yet. 4:48 is left here in the third quarter. ICC is going to have to hustle. Play clock now down to 10 seconds. Make it 8.
Call timeout. Come on, coach.
Now 5. Indians trying to hurry, and they're going to take the timeout. Coach Sean Cannon showing off that Jets. Running a 4-5-40 down there on the sideline to call that timeout. Jim, let's take the timeout with them. ICC leads this one 35-13. Trying to add to it here late in the third quarter, 4:48 to play. Back with more right after this.
Hi. It's me, Adam. And if you don't know, I'm a pretty lucky dude. Just take my 13th birthday. Just kidding. I skipped age 13. Straight from 12 to 14 like a 1930s elevator.
Happy birthday, sweetie. Is everyone having fun? Okay.
But you're not this lucky. No one is. So talk to a Farm Bureau agent today. Because when it comes to your coverage, luck should have nothing to do with it.
And welcome back to action, ladies and gentlemen, as we've got a lot of fans tuning in here on LetsGoICCTV.com, loving what they're seeing right now. One of those guys is Buddy Wayne Haynes back at ICC. He's recovering from shoulder surgery, but I tell you what, anytime that Let's Go ICCTV is on, Buddy Wayne is tuned in, so we do appreciate Buddy Wayne back there in Fulton, and do wish him a speedy recovery. This is going to be Dan Ellington on this snap. Gets it. He's just got a convoy, and he's going to leap into the end zone. And I tell you what, Jim, with those two big guys blocking him, you and I could have ran that one in.
He wasn't touched until he got to the end zone. Great job, Ellington. Great job by the offensive line. Good blocking by the up backs. We've taken commanding lead, 41-13. Still 4:38 left in the third quarter. But to be honest with you, and I'm not trying to jinx it, Hinds lost a little enthusiasm with that interception and a great play by ICC.
Jim, what about the play of Dan Ellington? We saw him last week, impressive outing. He's got 5 touchdowns tonight, 3 rushing, 2 passing. Awaiting the snap back is a good one. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Coach Sullivan might be watching at home saying, Ellis, let's save some of these kicks for tomorrow, as Zach Ellis adds that one. We're going to keep it here coming out of that break right now, Jim. 42-13, ICC really starting to open things up here in the third
quarter. You know, Ellington's playing very well, but I'll tell you what, I think Peyton Bender is playing outstanding also. He's throwing darts tonight. You know, Ellington's coming in, getting his series. Both quarterbacks are performing very well. And the people that we forget about, the offensive line's blocking for this. You know, making some great effort out there, opening up the holes. We got 42 points because our offensive line's blocking very well tonight.
Absolutely, and that's one thing. Those guys kind of don't get as much credit as they should, those big guys up front. But I tell you what, they're getting the job done tonight. We've only given up 1 sack that I can remember all night, and really very few plays for negative yardage in this contest. So the offensive line just bullying up and clearing the way for the Indians.
Good job, offensive line. We got to keep the momentum now. It's still a long time left in this ball game. It's 42-13. Indians up big. But there's 4:38 left in the third quarter. Need to keep the momentum, and the defense just needs to keep playing well. We've played very well this third quarter.
I tell you, somebody else is proud of the Indians' performance right now, and that's the fine folks at the First American National Bank, as they're getting another First American National Bank kickoff here from Zach Ellis. 42-13 is your score. 4:38 to go here in the third quarter. Ellis puts a foot into this one. End-over-end kick is going to be taken at about the 8-yard line by the Eagles, trying to cut it back up the middle. And bounces off 1 tackle, is going to be hit and dropped right around the 25. And that's pretty much, other than 2 big returns tonight, is where the Eagles have started off most of their possessions tonight, Jim.
Good job by Cody Shelton, linebacker from Ripley, Mississippi, made the stop. 1st and 10, Eagles at their own 26-yard line. And we mentioned the Indians up big at this time, 42-13, 4:24 left in the third quarter.
Yeah, and Jim, as you said, just like the way the Indians can put up points in a hurry, this Hinds offense does have that big strike ability. And you know they're going to have to try to open up the offense here to see if they can't go downfield a little bit to try to get back in this one. 1st down and 10. Xander, still your quarterback. Gibb is going to be to the running back. He's going to try to get to the outside, stretched out, and he's going to be hit and dropped right around the 30-yard line. I tell you what, that was a big-time boom put on that time by Freddie Jordan Jr. as he lowered his shoulder and bullied his way for a 5-yard gain, actually a 6-yard gain.
No doubt about it. Edwards on the tackle. That's a good-looking running back. He ran hard there around the end. 2nd down, 2nd and 4 for the Eagles. They got the ball at their own 32-yard line. 4 minutes left in the third quarter.
I stand corrected. That was actually King on the carry. Xander, this time the give into the backfield, and he is going to be stacked up. And a quick whistle, as they said, his forward progress was stopped. And so now they say a loss on the play, Jim. No, they're going to say no gain.
No gain. Good job by Kenny Wooten, the outstanding player from Meridian that's going to Arkansas State next year, made the stop there. 3rd down, 3rd and 4 for the Eagles. 3:30 left in the third quarter.
Yeah, this is where the Eagles really like to go with that slant pass. Trips up top, 1 receiver down low is Giddy. Looks like they've given a little signal from the quarterback to the receiver on the LSU commit on the sidelines. Play clock down to 8 seconds. Xander now gets the snap, bobbled. He's going to try to go long, lob down the sideline, it's going to be out of bounds. Once again, Xander, he's struggling, folks. He has not completed a pass so far, as my stats say, here in the second half. Hinds fans wanting a pass interference call, but everything he's thrown deep is going out of bounds.
He's been going out of bounds. He's got to put the ball in play, and that's what's helped our defensive backs. Xander's is making good throws, but they're all out of bounds. You cannot call interference on that.
And let's give a lot of credit to those linebackers and defensive linemen getting in the head and into the hip pocket of Xander here in the second half. Hinds back to punt this one again. Looks like this is going to be Octavius Matthews back to return now. A shift being put on here by Hinds. 4th and 4, low snap. Kick is up, and it's blocked! The Indians finally get one, and they fall on top of it. It don't matter if Hinds falls on top of it. It'll be a turnover on downs. Big time play by the Indians. Jim, we've been close all night. You kind of felt it coming. And the Indians block the kick, and they take over at the 2-yard line.
Good job by the Indians. Not at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, 22.
But a nice play by our special teams. As you mentioned, Adam, we've been close all night. We found a way to get it done then. I didn't get the number who blocked it. But great effort by our defense. First and 10 for the Indians at the 22-yard line of Hinds, trying to put some more points on the board.
Absolutely. 2:58 to play here. 42-13 is your score. Peyton Bender in at quarterback now for the Indians. Looks like this is going to be Hadley. Braden, before you text me, Hadley, hashtag them blankets, in at running back. Bender had to go find that snap. Now throw across the middle. Jump ball, and a beautiful play that time by the Eagles as coming in at the last second to break that one up was number 5, Butler, a sophomore defensive back out of Vicksburg.
He had him there. Looked like Terry Williams was open, but Butler made a great play to knock the ball down. We're not taking our foot off the pedal.
No.
Bender's throwing the ball. He's been throwing it well tonight. Let's see if we can take advantage of this field position.
Absolutely. We're going to try to find you some Trustmark Bank, some Bank of Oklahoma scoreboard updates here in a moment. Bender, a little delay give this time to Hadley. Hadley bounces off one, fights forward out near the 20-yard line. Gain of 2 on the play. I tell you what, he took a pretty gnarly hit that time when he got to the 20. Quickly bounces up and gives the ball back to the official. It'll be a third down and a short 9, long 8.
Third down, 3rd and 8. 2.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Indians up 42-13, trying to get some more points here. We're on the 20-yard line of the Eagles.
So the Indians trips up top, one receiver down low. Hadley in the backfield along with Bender, your quarterback. Bender gets the snap. Pass across the middle, wide open, out to the 10-yard line. That's going to move the chains. The ball came free, still free, and it goes out of bounds. Tough break there for Hinds as they were getting there in a hurry, and they're going to say it went out of bounds and it should stay with ICC. Yeah, they do not show that a change of possession. Now they're going to talk it over to see if it was a reception. Fumbled it back. It was scooped up and returned by Hadley. He was tattooed, and then the ball rolled out of bounds. So I think what they're doing is they're going to make sure that the ball is in the proper spot where it's marked. And if it is marked where it is, that's going to be another first down for the Indians.
First and goal, I believe, Adam. The ball's inside the 10-yard line.
And so the Indians do get the ball back as the ball rolled out of bounds. The ball is going to be at the 10. So it's going to be a first down brought to you by your Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox. First and 10, or first and goal, I should say, for the Indians, who lead 42-13. 2 minutes, 9 seconds to go here in the third quarter. I don't know how to stat that. It was a completion, a fumble return. Hadley with it. He's going to try to bounce it to the outside. Going to try to use a little bit of speed. Now gets out to the 10, down to the 5-yard line. Gain of 5 on the play that time by Hadley.
Good run by Hadley. Good stretch play. Good blocking by the offensive line. We're running some clock here, trying to get some more points. 1:40 left in the third quarter. ICC up big, 42-13, knocking on the door again.
Yeah, the Indians would not mind seeing this clock run a little bit quicker here. 42-13 is your score. 1:35 and counting. ICC, as Jim just mentioned, up 42-13 in the third quarter. This third quarter being brought to you by the ICC Wesley Foundation. Little misdirection play that time. Hadley gets it, spins off one guy, fighting forward. He squirts free after being wrapped up and almost broke that one ahead. You see a little pushing and shoving going on as Hinds comes up and kind of gives one of our players a shove, raises his hand, and quickly goes back. A nice gain that time. A gain of about 4 on the play as he gets it down to the 1.
Third and goal at the 1-yard line. We're under a minute here in the third quarter. Indians trying to punch it in again here.
Inside a minute to play now. Third and goal, ICC with it. This is going to be a give to Rogers. Rogers stumbles forward, but he's going to be stopped inside the 1, just inches away from punching that one in. And let's see if the Indians will let to go for it. I think they're actually going to come in and kick this one. No, excuse me, they may
bring Ellington in, run the power formation here with the big man up front.
Yeah, they may actually let this be the last play as the officials have not started the play clock yet. Or actually, I guess they're going to say don't start it because this is going to be enough time to run off here before the start of the quarter. So it's going to be a 4th down and 1 for the Indians. Dan Ellington comes into the contest. Once again, that big boy set here for the Indians. 9 seconds to play in the third quarter. Looks like the Indians are just going to elect to run this one out, and we're going to switch sides of the field. Big third quarter for the Indians as they take a 42-13 lead into the fourth quarter of play. We're going to take a break and be back with more here on Let's Go ICCTV.com and FM 95 Sports.
lover. There's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, brother, know the wild and sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, the sky comes falling down for you. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. If I'm far from home, oh brother, I will hear you call. If the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.
And welcome back to Action, ladies and gentlemen. We start the fourth quarter. This fourth quarter being brought to you by the Sonic of Fulton. It's buy one, get one free wings right now going on at Sonic. And Jim, I tell you what, I would buy two and get two free right now. I'm so hungry.
Can they ship them up here to Hinds for us?
I would love it. The Indians will have a fourth down and one situation here, or fourth down and goal from the one. And it looks like ICC is going to elect to come in and try actually shorter than a PAT right now, Jim. As this is going to be Zach Ellis to come in to attempt this kick. The ball is going to be spotted at the, is at the 7?
Yes, sir.
So a 17-yard kick here for Ellis. Snap back's a good one. The kick is up. The kick is true. Zach Ellis tacks on a 17-yard field goal as we get set to start the fourth quarter of play. Jim, let's keep it here since we just took you to a break. 45-13, ICC with the lead.
Good job by our defense and offense punching the ball down the field. Do you realize a 17-yard field goal is the shortest field goal that is possible?
Very true. Very true. I did not know that. So a little football 101 being brought to you by the ICC Foundation. Jim Ingram, you are the director of the ICC Foundation. Tell people how they can find out more about the ICC Foundation.
Adam, they can send me an email at jingram@iccms.edu. Give me a call on my telephone, 862-8047. We'd love to talk to you. We do a lot of good things for the college, raise money for scholarships for students, stipends for teachers, and other building projects. The foundation is very important for the college, just like everything that we do at ICC is very important. We'd love to hear from you and get you involved.
Absolutely. You can also visit, I think you did say it, but just in case you missed it, iccms.edu. If you're on letsgoicc.com, you can scroll to the bottom of the page. You'll see the icon there for the ICC Foundation for more information. Well, Zach Ellis is going to need the ice bath tonight, folks. He is going back for yet again another First American National Bank kickoff here as ICC leads this one 45-13. Ellis, end-over-end kick is going to be taken at about the 14-yard line. Going to try to get to the sideline. Breaks up the middle. Got one man to beat, and a nice open-field tackle by the Indians. That's Devin Hollis. And a little bit of extracurricular activity going on there on the side of Hinds. Credit that time, the ICC Indian, Deion Knox. He just laid on the field, did not get up and respond or react, and he just ran to the sideline. So good job, because we saw what happened on Netflix last year. And you know every coach across the league has made it a point to not react, not try to get anything to happen in those type of situations.
No doubt about it, Adam. And let's be honest, it's fourth quarter early, but we got a commanding 45-13 lead. Everybody needs to keep your composure here.
Give is going to be the long running back. Breaks off a tackle, slips off another, and it's going to be a gain of 11. No, make it 10 on the play. That's going to be number 25. That's going to be Scott, and I tell you what, he carried it one time in the first half for 12 yards. Second time he touched the ball, and he is carrying it for 10 yards, or making 11 now as they move it a little bit further forward. And so that's going to be another first down. Eagles in a hurry. Yeah, once again, it's going to be to Scott. Scott breaking it to the outside. He's got a lot of real estate across the 30, down near the 25-yard line. That is going to be a gain of 23.
Devin Hollins on the tackle, made a saving tackle, and then Hinds is moving up down the field here very quickly. First and 10, Hinds. They got the ball at ICC's 25. They're down 45-13 with 14 minutes left in the ball game.
Jim, at the next break, we'll give you a scoreboard update throughout the league being brought to you by the Bank of Oklahoma. First down and 10. Hinds with the football. Give is going to be to Scott once again. Scott's going to break up the field, slips off a tackle, and for the first time tonight, the Indians have stopped him short of a double-digit gain. Gain of 4 that time for Scott.
Good job by the Indians. Carruthers on the tackle, got a shirt jersey. Would not let go, brought him down. 13:30 left in the ball game. 45-13, ICC up on Hinds.
A Bank of Oklahoma scoreboard update. East Central leading Northeast 21-17. That's in the fourth quarter. Second down and eight. Hinds looking to pass. Pressure coming across the middle. Pass is deep, and it's too far. Looks like this may be a new quarterback in the game. I can't tell.
I can't tell either.
His number is... Looks like it's... I can't tell if it's 11 or 1. Looks like that is a new Desmond Hunter.
Desmond Hunter, a freshman quarterback, number 11 from Wilkinson County. He's in now at quarterback.
Well, the passing game has not been kind for Hinds here in the second half. Other scores throughout the league. Holmes up 28-14. That's 9:13 left in the fourth quarter over Southwest. Northwest starting to distance themselves from Pearl River. They're up 24-7. You've got Colan struggling with Cahoma. They're only up 12-0. Pass across the middle is caught, and that's going to move the chains. Nice job coming back to the football and catching it. Behind him that time was Chris Blair. Move the chains, and the Eagles moving with purpose. And you also got Jones County up 31-13 over Mississippi Delta, and East Mississippi starting to clear themselves with Gulf Coast. They're up 28-7 in the third quarter. So East Mississippi, the team that was number one in the country, trying to get a little bit of retaliation, I guess you can say, and get back. Now they have some of their players back on there. Those scoreboard updates being brought to you by the Bank of Oklahoma. First down and goal to go. Hinds going to lob it up, try to go to the corner of the end zone. Nothing there. And the official really letting them play over there on the corner, a little pushing and shoving going on by both guys for Hinds and ICC.
As you mentioned, Adam, the incomplete second and goal for Hinds, 12:30 left in the ball game. The score is ICC 45, Hinds 13, but we're going to hold them here. Hinds moving the ball down the field with their second-team quarterback. I believe we got some second-teamers in there. Also, defense, we played a lot of players tonight, keeping them fresh, doing a good job.
Absolutely. Remind you to stay tuned. We'll have the Mississippi Magnolia Gold post-game report coming your way at the conclusion of this one. Hopefully, you'll be able to get Coach Sean Cannon up here to talk to us. A little bit of a challenge to get him up here, as this is going to be a give. This is actually going to be the keeper by the quarterback. No, excuse me. It was not. Everybody gets tackled on the play. It was a give to Scott that time, and Scott is stacked up for no gain on the play.
Good job by the defense. Third and goal for Hinds. Marking the ball at the 11-yard line, I believe. Now they're moving it up back to the 9-yard line, but it's third and goal for Hinds. Big play by the ICC defense. Need to hold them.
So now it's at the 8.
They keep moving it up. They're going to be on the 1 in a minute.
They keep moving it without the players moving. The officials keep moving it up. But either way it goes, third down and goal here inside 12 minutes to play. Pass out in the flats, and the Indians saw that one coming a mile away, and they're going to hit and dropping for a significant loss, a loss of about 3 on the play, back to the 11. Jim, you said the 11 before. You just saw that coming ahead of time.
I was fortunate. And give our defense some credit. I mean, we're cruising. We've got this game in the bag, 45-13, let's be honest. But our defense is still playing hard, stopping them from getting to the end zone.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to let to go for it. Is Hinds here, 11:30 and counting. ICC with a 45-13 advantage here in the fourth quarter. This fourth quarter being brought to you by Sonic of Fulton. Looking to pass. Going to be a jump ball to the corner of the end zone, and it's going to fall incomplete. And once again, that one kind of thrown out of bounds. So I tell you, the Indians have caught some breaks tonight as these balls have floated out of bounds. There's been a couple of times the Indians have been a little bit too physical for my liking not to see a flag, but with the ball flying out of bounds the way it has, you can't really call it whenever it's an uncatchable ball.
Adam, give our defense credit. They had first and goal inside our 10, and we stopped them. We take them over the possession right here.
Yeah, the Indians would love to see a slow, methodical drive on this one, put some more points on the board, and then take this one to the house. 45-13 is your lead. We're in the fourth quarter. ICC trying to move to 2-0 on the season before heading to Senatobia next Thursday night to take on the defending national champions, who look like they'll be moving to 2-0 on the season as well. Roger Thomas on the carry. Going to fight forward for a minimum gain. The clock continues to roll. We're now inside 11 minutes to play.
Adam, I think we're going to run the ball quite a bit right here. Of course, they'll probably throw the bomb after I said that. But Bender's back in at quarterback. We're trying to run some clock. We got a commanding lead. We're playing some young players. Run the football. Run some clock.
Yeah, gain of 2 on the play that time by Rogers. And as you called it, Jim, they do throw the bomb downfield. A lot of contact. And I think if this is a closer contest, they would throw the flag. But it's one of those situations where the Indians up 45-13, maybe going for that home run ball to put it away there, Jim, and a lot of contact, but no flag thrown.
No flag, and like you said, Adam, it's the game, we got it in hand, it was very close there, but Bender made a good pass. Good job by the defensive back on the coverage.
Yeah, give him a little bit of practice for on down the line. Still a lot of season to play here. 46-13 is your score. 10:38 to play here. Third down and 7 for the Indians. Bender looking to pass. Plenty of time to throw. Pressure eventually breaks down. Now Bender's going to try to get out and run. He's still thinking about passing, and he's going to stumble forward out to a gain of about the 15.5 yard line. A whole lot of running for a 2-yard gain that time, but you got to like Bender's play. He was looking for maybe a DB to come in and try to make the tackle, and then maybe dump it off for an easy big-time game.
Good job. He kept the ball. No turnover. Let's punt it away. Get our defense back on the field. We've got 10 minutes left in the ball game. 45-13, ICC up on Hinds.
Well, Rip Kirk has not had a very busy night tonight.
Which is good.
Yeah, I think he may have punted twice tonight so far.
Correct.
So Kirk waiting for this. And Hinds did not have the proper people on the field. They're going to take a timeout here. We're going to take it with them here. A few words from our sponsors. ICC up in this one, 45-13 in the fourth quarter. We'll take a break and be back with more right after this on FM 95 Sports. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Oklahoma, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. And welcome back to action. As you saw all those sponsors there, Jim, without those sponsors, none of these broadcasts would be possible. And a special thank you to all those sponsors. And if you would like to sponsor ICC Athletics, give me a call at 862-8059. That's 862-8059. We've got various packages, affordable packages, to be able to get your message to go along with the number 11 team in the country, the ICC Indians.
No doubt, and we appreciate our sponsors. They're basically friends of ours. They do business with us, and they support us, and it means a lot to us.
Fumble on the fair catch, and the ball still loose, but I think Hinds fell on top of it. The Indians actually had a chance to fall on top of that one after the muff punt. They're going to kind of clean up the pile here. No official signal yet, but I do believe Hinds fell back on top of it, waiting the officials to show us who has it, and we're still waiting, and no signal, but apparently there's no turnover, as Hinds will keep the football. Well, Jim, we talked about the Indians need to come out and make a statement early in the second half, and they did so as they raced to a 45-13 advantage here with 9:36 left in the contest.
Adam, I thought the key point was, you know, they got the ball inside our 30 on two consecutive possessions early in the third quarter, and our defense stood up, stopped them, and then we took advantage offensively and scored some touchdowns and taken control of the ball game.
Absolutely. First down and 10. The ball is at the 40 on the positive side of the 50-yard line. It's at the 49. First down being brought to you by your Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox. Give is going to be to the running back. He's going to get to the outside. He's got an edge, and he's going to go forward. He's going to be hit and dropped near the 35-yard line. A gain of 13 on the play that time for the Eagles. That's going to be number 32 on the carry. That's Freddie Jordan Jr.
Knox and Lott on the tackle, but Freddie Norman's running very hard tonight. And as you mentioned, Adam, first down on ICC's 35-yard line. 9 minutes left in the ball game. ICC 45, Hinds 13.
Give once again is going to be to Jordan Jr. in the backfield. I tell you what, nice run that time by the young man from Hinds. He got hit at the line of scrimmage and just bullied his way forward short of the 30. Then we're marking him at the 31-yard line. Pretty good pickup there on first down.
Second down, second 5 for the Eagles. As you mentioned, the ball is at the 31-yard line of the ICC. 8 minutes, 40 seconds left in the ball game.
So the Indians with it. Hinds just trying to finish strong here. Pressure coming off the edge, pass across the middle. Oh, I think that time a little confusion between the secondary as that was batted down by number 3, David Little. And I think what he did was he stopped Donald Twilley from being able to intercept that one that time. A break there for the Eagles.
But still good job by Twilley and Little because they're there at the ball. Good coverage by the Indians knocking that ball down. Third down, 3rd and 6 for the Eagles.
So it will be a 3rd down and 6 situation, as Jim said. We're now in the 9 o'clock hour here in Raymond, a long drive home. We do appreciate those tuning in here on letsgoicctv.com. We want to challenge you to make that short drive out to Senatobia next week as that pass is complete out to the 25-yard line, hit and dropped. looks like that's going to be good for a first down here for the Eagles.
Yeah, we do need a good crowd. How long? It's not a long drive from the Fulton area.
2 hours.
And we need them there to support this team, which will be 2-0 next week, and moving up the ranks and playing very well, playing good football for your school.
Absolutely. So we do encourage you. That will be a 6:30 kickoff there. Boy, Jim, we've defeated Gulf Coast. Looks like we're going to be able to hold on here and defeat Hinds. Man, we got the defending national champions at their place. It would be big if we could find a way to move to 3-0 in the season. Pass out in the flats is complete, and it's going to be good for another first down, a pickup of 12 that time by the Eagles.
ICC substituting multiple players in right now here late in the ball game. We mentioned there's 7.5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. ICC 45, Hinds 13. But it's first and 10 for Hinds. I think the ball is at the 15-yard line of the Indians.
We do want to remind you that we will be back on the air here on FM 95 Sports. That Davis Ford pregame show will start at 6:10. We'll also be here on letsgoicctv.com/red. Give off the middle. Man going up the middle, and he's going to be hit, stuck at the 5-yard line, still fighting to try to go forward. And really surprised that the officials let that one carry on as long as they did, especially after the young man lost his helmet. But it looks like it's going to be good for another first down for the Eagles. These first downs being brought to you by your Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox.
First and goal for the Eagles. They got the ball at ICC's 2-yard line. 7 minutes left in the ball game. Indians up 45-13.
And the Eagles trying to get in the end zone here. Their secondary has played, or second team, I should say, has played extremely well. Gibb is going to be to the long running back. He stretches it forward, loses the football, and they're going to say he was down. They said he was down as he made the stretch, and the ground cannot cause the fumble. Said his knee was down at the 1-yard line. So a break there for the Eagles, because ICC was actually, I think, going to let that one roll out of the back of the end zone, and that would have been a touchback.
Touchback, get the ball at the 20-yard line, but they called him down. I think it's a correct call. Second and goal, the ball's at our 1-yard line.
Late substitution into the game here, as coming back into the contest for the Eagles is number 32. That's going to be Freddie Jordan Jr. And hello, the Indians defense. It's late in the night, but they're still not wanting to give one up that time, as that was Lee Autry, a half a ton of hostile humanity coming in and making the play that time.
Not nice call there. And it was second and goal for one. Autry knocked them down at the 4-yard line. It's third and goal for four. Let's keep them out of the end zone. You know Sean Cannon doesn't want to see a touchdown right now.
Absolutely. Head coach, also the defensive coordinator, so he is takes a lot of pride in that ICC defense. Campus police tuning in here saying, go Indians. Want to give a shout-out to the campus police there. Big time hit. Did they get the pass off? How did he get the pass off? Wow, he threw that one between the arms of Lee Autry. Touchdown for the Eagles. I thought Autry had batted that one down, but that was a 4-yard touchdown pass. I believe that was number 10 who came away with it. There is no number 10, so that is not number 10, obviously. I'm trying to see who that young man is. They have very difficult numbers to read here.
It is. It's a wide receiver on Hinds. Let's just put it that way.
Looks like number 12, maybe. Chris Blair, a freshman with that touchdown reception.
That makes the score ICC 45, Hinds 19, pending the extra point.
The kick is up, and it's good.
45-20 here, fourth quarter, 5 minutes, 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Hinds will be kicking off to our Indians.
We're going to take a break, be back with more right after this. ICC up 45-20 here on the road at Hinds. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Okolona, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. And welcome back to action here, ladies and gentlemen, as we have... We had somebody text you, Jim, so if you want to figure that out, tell me what it was. I couldn't
No, that's fine. That's fine. We got some, you know, we appreciate people listening to us, watching us on TV. This guy's traveling throughout the, doing some business in Columbus, Starkville, West Point. He's hearing this loud and clear, said it sounds good.
Awesome. We do appreciate them tuning in there on FM 95 Sports. Salisbury takes the kick at the goal line. He's going to bring it out. Now cuts back to the middle. Trying to break free. Gets across the 20. Still fighting forward. Salisbury's going to be hit and dropped right around the 22-yard line is where the Indians will have it with another Itawamba County Farm Bureau agent, Joey Cox. I just totally lost what I was talking about there.
No problem. It's late at night. It's been a lot of scoring. And the Indians, we're happy to say, are up 45-20 with 5 minutes, 25 seconds left in the ball game. First and 10 Indians, and let's see what quarterback's coming in right now. I believe Bender's coming back in.
And that does seem to be the case here for the Indians. Or no, let's see. This is actually going to be number 17 coming into the game. This is going to be Montario Montgomery, the freshman from Starkville, seeing his first action of the season. Montgomery takes the shotgun snap. Give is going to be to the long running back. This is going to be, I believe, Hadley, who is spun around and dropped at the 25-yard line. Gain of 2 or 3 on the play.
Glad to see the freshman get some time in here. Montgomery, we know, is a great athlete. I think he's even played some defensive back for us in the past. He's in the ball game right now. 5 minutes left in the game. Second down, 2nd and 8.
So gain of 2 there for Hadley. Actually, I'm going to give him maybe a gain of 3.
I believe so. Yeah, second down, second
and
7.
3 on the play. So the Indians take a little bit of time here, trying to work as much of this clock as they can as it continues to roll here. 4:40 and counting, ICC with a 45-20 advantage. Give is going to be to Hadley. He's going to be hit and dropped for a loss that time. Looks like maybe are actually going to give him a little forward progress. So a loss of 1 on the play that time by Hadley. 6 carries, 17 yards for the Tupelo native. Jim, it'd be interesting to talk to Coach Sean Cannon after the game in our Mississippi Magnolia Gold post-game report. And we probably have to kind of stall a little bit for him to be able to get through this crowd. A good crowd coming out tonight for Hinds. Not a bad crowd making the drive down. About a 4-hour drive from ICC to Hinds here. The Indians, once again, taking their time. Play clock now down to 15 seconds. 3rd down and 8.
Just went under 4 minutes of the ball game. We appreciate the fans coming out tonight. We appreciate you listening on the radio and watching on TV. But it's a good night for the Indians up here, 45-20 here, late in the ball game.
Indians elect to keep this one on the ground. The give is going to be to Hadley. Looks like a gain of 3 once again for the native of Tupelo. 7 carries unofficially for 20 yards. And the Indians will send out the punting unit as Rip Kirk will come back out here to punt this one away. Well, Jim, the Indians just pretty much said, okay, we're just going to run the clock out here on offense, not try to do anything big. Kirk's going to come in, and the Indians having a late substitution in here. It looks like this is going to be number 5 for Hinds back to receive. That's going to be Kareem Butler out of Vicksburg. A little confusion by the Eagles as well, and the Indians sending in a late substitution once again. Late in the game, not paying much attention on either side of the sidelines. That's not going to be good for film review tomorrow. Good snap back to Rip Kirk. High kick spiraling deep into the Raymond Knight. Fair catch is caught right about the 38 yard line is where the Eagles will have it. They trail 45-20, 2:47 to play here in the contest. Well, Jim, the Indians, they took care of business in the third quarter.
They did. And we mentioned, I keep mentioning this, great defensive stands when they had the ball inside our 30 twice in a row. And then we took advantage offensively, I think, went down and got 3 consecutive touchdowns. We turned it around in the third quarter and just took the game over.
Looks like a new quarterback into the contest here for Hinds. This is going to be J.P. Elkins, a freshman quarterback out of Ridgeland High School, coming into the contest. 1st down and 10. Low snap. Gives it off to the running back. Fumble. I believe Hinds fell back on top of it. Yes, they did. A loss of 1, maybe 2 on the play, as that was number 32 for the Eagles coming up and fumbling it. That's Freddie Jordan Jr., but he was able to get back on top of it. Loss of 2, 2nd down and 12.
Good job by the defense, and we don't want to give up any more points. It's 45-20. They played very well tonight. Let's stop them here.
2nd down and 12. High snap. Passes almost intercepted. Nice job by Deion Knox anticipating that play that time. Could have been a pick 6 if he was able to find a handle on that.
He jumped the pattern. He saw the pattern down and out, and he jumped it. Almost picked it off. She mentioned if he did, it would have gone to the house.
So 3rd down and 12. Clock is stopped with 2:10 here in the fourth quarter. Indians trying to move to 2-0 on the season. Try to keep an eye on that Northwest game, as that's who the Indians have next in Senatobia. That game will be Thursday night. We do encourage all the ICC fans to come out, wear your red, and support the good guys. Pass down the field, wide open. hit and knocked down shy of the 50-yard line, but good enough for a first down, a gain of 11 on the play. And, Jim, nice job by the freshman quarterback throwing across his body, making the strike for the first down.
Good pass by the freshman. First down for the Eagles. Keep possession. A minute 45 left in the ball game. 45-20. Indians up big.
Northwest is up in their contest. We're going to take a look at some Bank of Oklahoma scoreboard updates. First down and 10. Pressure coming. The Indians in the backfield, and they drop him for a loss of about 5 on the play. Jim, let's take a look at some Bank of Oklahoma scoreboard updates throughout the league. East Central up 21-17 over Northeast. That's in the fourth quarter. Your score here, 45-20 with 1:15 to play in the contest. Holmes, 34-20 in the fourth quarter over Southwest. Northwest up 31-14 over Pearl River. That one in the fourth quarter. You've got Colin, 19-0 over Kahoma. That one in the third quarter. 38-3, Jones County over Delta. Second down and 15. Pass is nearly picked off again. Nice job of jumping the route. And I tell you what, Jim, the Indians came close to 2 pick-6 on that drive. And your final score. This is actually in the third quarter. East Mississippi 31-7 over Gulf Coast.
They're pulling away, and we knew they'd get back right, getting all their players back. They're playing very well.
Your score here, as we said, 45-20. Inside a minute to play now. Third down and 15 after that incomplete pass stops the clock. So this one pretty much all but final. Passes out. Nice tip pass. Oh, nice defense that time, as that was number 3. David Little almost tipped that one to himself for the interception. So the Indians have come close to picking off 3 passes on this drive. So it's going to bring up a fourth down and 15. Looks like Holmes will punt this one away. And, Jim, you got to thank the Indians. It's going to be the best play call for a head coach, or excuse me, an offensive coordinator to call going to that victory kneel.
Victory kneel here. We got 43 seconds left in the ball game. 45-20, a very, very nice victory. Good team effort tonight. I don't know who you give the most valuable player or who you give the player of the game
to. Well, you got to thank Dan Ellington with 5 touchdowns in the contest. Another nice punt here by Hinds is going to hit and roll. Salisbury is going to get it. He's going to try to slip out some tackles. And Salisbury, I'm telling you folks, if he can ever slip one of those initial tackles, that kid has big playability. Showed it off there as he just kind of wiggled his way forward for a pretty exciting 2-yard return.
No doubt about it. All right, Adam, 29 seconds, getting the victory formation. Let's get out of here with a big victory.
Absolutely, Jim. The Indians looking to move to 2-0 on the season here with this win over the Hinds Eagles. Indians ranked number 11 in the country will travel to Senatobia next week to take on Northwest, the defending national champions. That game will be at 6:30. We do want to encourage all ICC fans to come out and support the Indians on the road in Senatobia. Waiting for the officials to mark the ball, start the clock, and the Indians are going to kneel their way to victory here. There's the knee, and that should do it. Your final score here from Hinds in about 20 seconds. And kind of just jumping the gun here, actually.
Well, they're running to the bench. The game's over. As you mentioned, Adam, we've won 45-20. A great victory, a very, very fine victory for victorious ICC Indians.
Absolutely. Count it down, Indian fans. 3-2-1, and ICC picks up the 45-20 victory here on the road against the Eagles as we move into our Mississippi Magnolia Gold post-game report. And, Jim, what a big-time second half for the Indians to pull away for this victory.
No doubt about it, Adam. We had a lead at halftime, but we knew that Hinds could come back. And I keep mentioning they had the ball inside our 30 twice there early in the third quarter. We stopped them, and then we took control, had 2 or 3 touchdowns, I think, in the third quarter, and pulled away with the victory. A great, great victory for our team.
Absolutely. The Indians do score 21 points there in the third quarter. They add a field goal in the fourth. We'll give you your complete scoring recap after this break. ICC wins it 45-20. We're going to take a break and be back with more of the Mississippi Magnolia Gold postgame report. We remind you, for more information on the Mississippi Magnolia Gold program, text 4GOLD. That's 4GOLD to 95577. That's 95577 for more information on the Mississippi Magnolia Gold program. Back with more of the Mississippi Magnolia Gold postgame report right after this on FM 95 Sports.
Thank you. Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, brother, know the wild and sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, the sky comes falling down for you. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. What if I'm falling?
ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Okolona, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we're here in the Mississippi Magnolia Gold postgame report. Reminding you once again, for more information on the Mississippi Magnolia Gold program at ICC, text 4GOLD, that's 4GOLD, to 95577. You see the Indians huddled up there at the end of the night, Jim. They're victorious 45-20 to move to 2-0 on the season.
No doubt, Adam. Very proud of our team, proud of our fans for coming, proud of you listening on the radio and watching us on TV. We took care of business. We knew that Hinds would be ready tonight. They came out, they took the early 6-0 lead, but we never flinched. We came back, took a lead at halftime, and really took control in the third quarter. All areas of the game, offense, defense, special teams played very well tonight, and that's why we're 2-0.
Absolutely. You can visit letsgoicc.com for those stats tomorrow afternoon, probably, once the coaches get it to us. We also do want to remind you, you can watch WCBI for highlights of tonight's victory. Robbie Donahoe and company doing a great job there covering ICC athletics. We see Coach Sean Cannon making his way up here. Jim, let's take a look at the scoring recap for the Indians, or excuse me, for the entire game tonight. The thing started off good for Hinds. They scored on a 63-yard touchdown pass from Zanders to Gideon, or no, that's not right. What's that kid's name?
Gidry.
I've called him everything tonight, folks.
That's okay.
Yeah, that kick failed. It was 6-0 with 9:42 to go there in the first quarter. Then in the first quarter, ICC got a 5-yard touchdown run by Dan Ellington. Ellis added the kick, 6:26 to go here in the first quarter. In the second quarter, 6-yard touchdown run by Matthews. Ellis kick, 14-6 in favor of the Indians with 12:27 to play in the second quarter. 7:48 to go in the second quarter. 3-yard touchdown run by Harris gives Hinds, or cuts the lead to 14-13 after that touchdown run at the 7:48 mark for Hinds. Kick added by Solly. In the second quarter, 6 minutes left in the second quarter, ICC scores on a 1-yard touchdown run from Dan Ellington. Zach Ellis added the kick. 21-13 is your score. 6:55 mark of the third quarter, Dan found Chris Long for a 6-yard touchdown pass. Ellis added the kick, 25-13 Indians. And then it was all Indians here in the third quarter, ladies and gentlemen. 81-yard touchdown pass from Ellington to Williams. Ellis kick, 35-13. And then Ellington runs 8 yards. Ellis added the kick again, 42-13, 4:13 to go in the third quarter. A 17-yard field goal from Zach Ellis made it 45-13. And then Hunter found Blair. And then the added kick there in the fourth quarter gives you your final score of 45-20. I tell you what, Coach Sean Cannon just got up here. We're going to give him a chance. Are you ready now?
Oh, we're good, bro.
I like this. Coach said he's good to go. And Coach Sean Cannon, man, 2-0 in the season, a good second half for the Indians.
Yeah, and we kind of, you know, slept walk through the first half. And, you know, just didn't have any fire, you know, and went in and challenged them at halftime. You know, I said, we're not playing the type of football we can, that we should be playing. And we came out and made plays. We had, you know, the block kick. We had the turnovers on defense. You know, we had the big plays on offense. And that looked more like what we foresee ourselves to be as a football team in that second half.
Well, Coach, you got close on two or three punts there towards the end in the first half. finally broke through and blocked one. That's always kind of something the Indians do well, is be able to get after the kickers, force some on them, and be able to block some kicks.
Well, you know, it was really – we practiced it this week. You know, we worked on it every day in practice. And, you know, and just like with our punt protection, we work on it every day as well. And, you know, because those are momentum changers. You get a punt block or you block a punt or whatever, you know, it is always huge. Really wasn't pleased with our kickoff coverage as much. But you know, when you kick off that much – like we did, yeah. You know, they're going to make some plays. But real proud of our kids, especially in the second half, come back playing with great effort.
Coach, defense was intense tonight, really put a lot of pressure on the quarterback. He came out, lit us up in the first half, but the second half adjustments, you guys were able to kind of put more pressure on him, and a lot of his passes just ended up out of bounds.
Yeah, you know, and we knew they were a deep ball offense, and Seven's a great player. I mean, I'm thinking, man, but they really never came back to that play,
no.
You know. And we challenged our D-line and our backers. I said, hey, you know, quarterback's got all day to throw. That's y'all's fault, you know. And so I thought our guys really, really played with a lot more passion in the second half. And first road trip, all that, you know, and the atmosphere. I said, look, guys, there's no chop being played. The band's not here, you know. So I said, this is a junior college visiting game. You know, we're on the road, so your crowd is not going to be as good as at home. So I think our kids finally, once we made some plays, kind of woke up and then ended up making our plays and winning the ball game.
Coach, you went with two quarterback attack. Bender, Ellington. Ellington passed for two touchdowns, ran for three more, our Sonic star of the game. But Bender came out, did well. I've got him unofficially for 11 of 16 for 106, or excuse me, 13 of 19 with one interception and 165 yards passing. Really forces the defense to be on their toes when you got two guys that can come out and perform at a high level.
Yeah, you know, and we started Bender this week. Just felt like that he's kind of more of a rhythm guy. And we knew Dan was going to be a third down, come in the game type deal. And, you know, and it's a good problem to have. You know, we've got a 1-2 punch there. You know, you hear the old Thunder and Lightning talk about the backs. But, you know, I think we've got a really good situation there at quarterback, because both of them do give you something different, you know, in what they bring to the table. So, but real just proud of our offense in that second half. You know, we really come out and took it to them. And, of course, it helped they had short fields, because we got some turnovers on defense. And all of it works together.
Absolutely. Also talking about Thunder and Lightning, four sides of Thunder and Lightning attack unofficially on the night, 12 carries for 70 yards. Well, Coach, short-lived celebration tonight after you pick up the win. Big-time game as we step into division play next week. We travel to Senatobia to take on the defending national champs.
Yep. Good football team. I don't know what their score was tonight, but I kept hearing a few that they were up. It's a big game because it's the next game. You know, it's the third game on our schedule. We'll get the adjustments made off this film. We'll watch this film tomorrow and put it to bed and get ready and get prepared for Northwest. But also our first division game. You know, so there's a lot on this ball game here. But I'm very proud of our kids after 2 weeks being 2-0, and that's one thing that, you know, we got to keep our momentum going.
Coach, to answer that question, Northwest defeats Pearl River 31-14, so they too move to 2-0. Coach, last week we had a record number of people watching ICC Athletics. Over 2,500 people tuned in to the football game. Over 3,000 as a whole turned in for football and soccer last week. People listening on FM 95 Sports, blowing up our phones all night. Coach, there's a lot of excitement behind this football team.
Well, you know, and I will commend our coaches of staying on our kids, you know, and that's kind of been our philosophy. We tell them the week is ours as coaches. That's our week, and then you guys get to do it on game day, and that's one thing we've done. We've tried to hold our feet to the fire and you know, practicing hard and doing the little things, and you know, and making their plays and just, you know, and all those things, and hopefully, you know, that they'll start seeing some of that, you know, come true of the things that we're preaching.
Absolutely. Well, Coach, congratulations on the big 45-20 win. We got a long ride home, so we're going to cut you free.
Yeah.
Congratulations, and hey.
Got to go see my wife.
There you go.
See her yet.
Yeah, and she'll fuss at me if I hold you too long. So, Coach, congratulations on the big victory. We're going to step away and come back after a 20-second timeout and wrap up the Mississippi Magnolia Gold postgame report right after this on FM 95 Sports. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Oklahoma, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic. Well, Jim, as we wrap up the Mississippi Magnolia Gold postgame report, we do want to remind everybody, text 4GOLD, that's 4GOLD, to 95577 for more information on the Mississippi Magnolia Gold program there at ICC. Jim, your final thoughts on the night?
Good win, Adam. You know, on the road with a young team, we came down here, got behind, but we kept our composure. I've been talking about composure tonight. Our team, our coaches had them prepared. Our players were prepared. They executed a game plan. They found a way to win the game, and we're 2-0 playing the national champions next week.
Absolutely. We do want to encourage all the ICC fans to come out and support the Indians in Senatobia next weekend. That First American National Bank kickoff will be at 6:30. If you can't make it, we want you to listen here on FM 95 Sports or FM95Radio.com, or give us a watch here on Let'sGoICCTV.com. So for Miss Tina Harlow, Jim Ingram, Lee Adams, Raphael Henry, Austin Blancett, and we've also got Haston McKissick out tonight, so we'll have plenty of reactions from tonight's victory here over Hinds. Your final score, 45-20. We'll see you next week in Senatobia. Good night. ICC Athletics on FM 95 Sports is presented by Little Caesars, Bank of Okolona, the ICC Baptist Student Union, First American National Bank, the ICC Wesley Foundation, Coca-Cola and the North Mississippi Coca-Cola Bottlers, the ICC Alumni Association, the ICC Foundation, Davis Ford, and Sonic.